Alright guys, so welcome back.
This is gonna be 39. Woot. So today we're gonna head over and venture on Route 27, and we're gonna try to head over and go through Tojo Falls. But this guy says, do you know what you just did? You've taken your first step in Kanto. Check your map. Well, actually, if you check your map right now, it's not gonna show that you're in Kanto. So just disregard that. I think I explained already that I'm gonna do the Kanto half on my crystal version. Anyway, so this girl comes out and she says that she's been doing training since her last battle. Now, if you guys don't remember who this is, this is the niece of the Scenewood's island gym leader. So she says she's done some training, but not as much training as I've done. So won't be too hard to take her down. She's got a Metang, which you probably haven't seen yet. So that's something new. She's got a Haunter, which I'm going to switch for. I'm going to switch to Paper Luigi because he's got a Bite, which is a Dark-type move, which does x2 damage against Ghost-types. So she sends out Haunter. So we're going to Bite, like I said. Shadow Punch, it's just quicker than, it takes advantage of your speed. One of the things I really wish they had in this game is the move Sucker Punch, which is Indominant Pearl, and it's a dark type move with 5 power points, and power point is how many times you can use the move, if you didn't know that. I should have explained that really early instead of in part 39. But and what it does is if your opponent's going to attack you, the move works ahead of the attack, so even if their speed's faster than yours, it'll still attack. You'll still attack first. So it's a really good move. I suggest if you have a slower Pokemon that you teach it that move, especially I know a lot of people that have Dust Noirs, which is the evolved form of Dusclops from Duskull. So Duskull, Dusclops. And then you trade with a Reaper Cloth and you get Dusk Noir, which is kind of a funny name because Noir, N-I-O-R, is French for black. So it's like dark black, you know, dusk, nighttime, and then noir, black. But anyway, so I didn't want to try to get Paper Luigi out on this Gardevoir. So brought out Motosurf, just trying to use a rollout, I'm pretty sure I'm going to keep rollout on Motosurf. You know, it's a really good move. But anyway, yeah, Sucker Punch is a good move. I know a Sudowoodo can learn it, so if you have a slower Sudowoodo, that's good. But yeah, Dusknoirs, Gengars, you can pretty much breed it onto a Pokemon real easy, depending on how you do your chain. But yeah, it's a pretty useful attack. So, as you saw, Gardevoir has synchronized, but it didn't work for the burn because I'm already a fire type. So, my fire type negated the burn status from the Gardevoir. Motosurf levels up. Ugh. It's totally a good pick. Alright. So, she's just telling you that you probably won't have problems with the Pokemon League. She says, beat the Elite Four for me. I realize the text isn't up when I say that, but, you know, it's it. Anyway, so just checking my team. Coming here. Says, water's thy deep blue. Do you want to surf? Yes. Come over here and grab this. This is a Moonstone. If you have a Jigglypuff or a Clefairy from way before that you're using for a special defense shield or a I do have my horsey with me. Okay. Anyway, for a special defense shield or as a stat setup Pokemon, you can evolve it into a Clefable. Or if you're using a Jigglypuff for the same thing, you can do a Wigglytuff. Anyway, so you come out of Tojo Falls, which is that little blip that you just saw, two waterfalls, and it pretty much just kind of separates the two. But anyway, you come across this trainer. You know, she's got a Bulbasaur. Now, Bulbasaur is Poison and Grass type, so Thunder Punch, I'm amazed, did as much as it did, but I suppose with the level difference plus Bulbasaur is just a level 1, while Ampharos is a level 3 evolution. Ampharos is going to have a little more of an advantage. So just taking down the Bulbasaur. I'm going to use Ivy Sword, so I'm going to switch to Motor Surf. And I'm not too worried about the low health, because I know my Motor Surf's going to be a little faster than her Ivysaur, so I'm just going to quick hit up a Flame Wheel on it, take advantage of its grass type. Anyway, and then she's got a Venusaur coming out third, so she really took her time organizing her Pokemon and leveling them up. Now, Venusaur, the level that it is actually the level that it evolves. A lot of people don't understand, but the first season Pokemon, they all evolve at level 16, but they don't all evolve at 36. Venusaur actually evolves at level 32, which can take some trainers by surprise when it says, oh, your Ivysaur leveled up at 32, and then it says, your Ivysaur is evolving, and you're going, huh, what? No, there's 34 more levels. No. Ivysaur evolves at level 32, so it's semi-useful, especially like when you're, at 32, I suppose you could have an Ivysaur before the second gym if you played ahead, which is what I'll be doing on either my Monotype Leaf Green or my Ashes Team Yellow. I haven't figured out, I'm doing a test run on my Yellow cartridge right now, my actual Game Boy Color cartridge, or Game Boy cartridge on my Pokemon Yellow version. Trying to do Ashes Team, which for the people that are watching this that haven't watched the anime ever, Ashes Kanto Team consisted of a Pikachu first, and then a Caterpie second, and then a Pidgeotto, and then during the Samurai episode, his Caterpie evolved into Metapod. No, it was before. It evolved into Metapod, and then the next episode it evolved into Butterfree, which is the Beedrill episode. So then his team consisted of Pikachu, Butterfree, and Pidgeotto. And then after his Pidgeotto, it was the Charmander that was abandoned. And then the... I think it's the Bulbasaur. The Bulbasaur from the daycare. And then the Squirtle from the Squirtle Squad. Now, I will be doing the game the way that I would do it. I'll be playing ahead. They'll let you guys know how I play the game. I'm going to go... Pout Town, Viridian Forest, Viridian City, Viridian Forest. And I will actually do the walking around to catch the Pidgeotto like Ash did, not just catch a Pidgey and evolve it, because that would take too long. Anyway, because Ash caught a Pidgeotto, not a Pidgey, but a Pidgeotto. And then I'm going to go Pewter City, do Mount Moon with those three, just going to be really tough. I go do everything in Cerulean City but the gym, and then I go ahead down to Vermilion City, do everything there except for the gym, and then after Vermilion City, I do the East Route of Vermilion City, and then I do the Rock Tunnel, Lavender Town, Celadon City, I do the routes in between those, and then after I do Celadon City, I go... because by then I'll have my bike, and then you have to do Rocket Game Corner, and then you do Ghost Tower, and then you do Rocket Hideout, or the Rocket Tower in Saffron. And then after that, you can go down the east and west sides of Saffron City. So the west side of Celadon and the east side of Lavender, I'll go down those routes, get to Fuchsia City, and then after I'm in Fuchsia City, I'm going to do the Safari Zone. And then hopefully by then, and then the next one after that is my gym badge rush, where I go and do Misty, Lieutenant Surge, Erica, Sabrina, and Koga all right away. And that'll put me up all the way up to, Blaine, because pretty much you can go all the way to Fuchsia City without needing any of the HMs, unless you want Cut or Fly. You only need is what you get from Misty. So actually, to do Rock Tunnel, you'll have to beat Misty. So then, I'll put Misty before. this is the end of the video, so we're gonna head back, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.